Hi everyone, how's it going? As you're learning Kubernetes, many of you may have considered getting CKA certified. You need to pass a certified Kubernetes admin exam to achieve this, and that's more accessible to relevant job opportunities. Time management is crucial in this exam. There are many tricks to help you succeed. In this video, I'll show you the most important time-saving trick in the CKA exam, so make sure you watch the entirety of the video. To complete the demo of this video, make sure you have Kubectl and Docker installed, which are covered in this video. Then it would be helpful if you also had a minikube cluster. Check out this video to learn more about how to spin up a minikube cluster in 2 minutes. If you want to build a lab environment with M1 MacBook, check out this video to learn how to play VMWare Fusion for free with M1 and M2 Macs. The links are in the description down below. Let's get right into it. Firstly, to create a deployment, we use kubectl create deployment command. This command will create a Kubernetes deployment for you, where you can specify the number of replica for your pod, and use --image to specify the container image in this command. Another command I use very often that you definitely should remember for the exam is kubectl run command. Use those commands will help you create a deployment in a matter of seconds. We'll give some time here to the pod to be up and running. You can use kubectl get deployment command to see the pods already. Sometimes in CKA exam, it will be very helpful for you to use kubectl get pod -o YAML command to be able to export a YAML definition when you create a pod using command. Then you can edit the YAML file to make a modification as you wish. Starting work with the deployment that you are not familiar with, you can use kubectl describe command to get the details. If you want to learn more about the deployment in YAML definition, check out this video for more details. Interestingly, you can also use kubectl edit command to live edit a deployment, and all the parameters are editable, but you can still fix a lot of things by doing this, such as fixing tags, labels, or other tiny details. Finally, you can also delete the deployment by using kubectl delete command. This is a command that will help you delete a number of replica of this deployment on the go. And it's relatively simpler, just kubectl delete plus a name of deployment, minus n if this deployment is in a different namespace other than the default. Thanks for watching. Check out this Kubernetes in 30 days challenge playlist in the description down below. I'll see you guys in the next one.